In lesson 4, we created an empty Python part which do not have any properties dialog yet. So in this lesson, we will create a properties dialog for this Foundation Python part. Open the link pythonparts.ALLPLAN.com, then click to how to define a PYP file. Here we could find the detailed instruction of ALLPLAN for how to create many different value types, such as integer, double, length, etc. Other good sources are in example, roto example, public examples. You will see many examples here. Open all control Python parts and take a look at all parameter types. We could find the code of these examples at etc library pythonparts example public examples. Open the PYP file and find the code for value type we are looking for. Now let's write our first dialog. Open SingleFoundation.py file, which we created in the previous lesson. We have nothing yet in batch element. For batch element, we need two nodes, name and text. Each node has open and close tag. Inside is the value of that node. Node name can be used in our Python script to identify the element. Node text will be used to display the name of the page if we have a multi page. Now let's write parameter for length of the foundation. Use node parameter to define a parameter. Every parameter node must have three child nodes, a unique name node, text node, and value type node. Similar to page element, node name will be used in our Python script to identify element, so it must be unique. We could use any name, but it must follow the rule of Python variable. Do not use space here. Text will be used to display in dialog. We are free to input space here. Value type for length could be inputted at integer, double, or length. We should use length because it could change the value adapt to our setting unit. Run the tool. And now we could see an input for foundation length in the dialog. Default value is 0. We could set the default value by node value. Default unit in millimeter. Now value is changed to 200 millimeter. If we change the unit, the default value will change accordingly. We can add comments for easy editing later. Similar for width and height, copy length parameter and edit it. To be more visual, we should group parameters by an expander. Expander is defined similar to length. It's also a parameter with name, text, value type, value child nodes, unique name, display text, value type must be expander. Value could be true or false. True defines a collapsed expander. False is an open expander. Move length, width, and height parameters inside the expander.
Now run the tool, and you can see that side parameters are wrapped into an expander. It could be open or collapsed expander. That's it for our first properties dialog. We will create other value types in the next lesson. Thank you for watching and see you.